Hey guys, welcome back to CC Home and Garden. So in today's video, we're actually gonna be taking a tour of Cornell Farms. One of the great things about this place is that they sit on a little over 5 acres and they grow about 800 different annuals and perennials in-house. So they really focus on the plant and the health of the plant. So you know you're always gonna be getting quality plants and perennials when you come here. Another great thing about Cornell is that they have a cafe right on their property and they serve the most amazing coffee and food. So when you're here, make sure to stop by and grab something to eat. Another great thing about Cornell is that they really try to work with local growers. So that's always really nice when you have a nursery that's going to support local business. Let's go inside and see what they've got going on today. And this is kind of their entrance to the kitchen garden, but they do have some beautiful shrubs laid out here as well. So I'm just gonna take you guys through and we'll go right to the kitchen garden. As you're walking through, especially during the summertime, this whole grapevine is just full of clusters of really, really delicious, beautiful grapes. As you guys know, or if you don't know, I love figs. And I've gotten so many of my figs here. They have quite a variety of different figs at Cornell. And they're always just beautiful specimens. All right, guys, so this is part of their kitchen garden. And as you can see, they're just packed full of veggie starters. If you didn't start any of your own seedlings this year, this is gonna be your perfect place to come get them. They really do grow premium plants and vegetables at Cornell. And as you can see, like, there's just tons and tons of variety of everything. See, we are here in the morning time and they stock everything all of the time. So, you know, I don't ever have to worry about coming here and not finding something because they're so good at keeping their inventory up all of the time. So as we leave the kitchen garden, we're gonna be heading out into this area where they have a lot of their berries, their vines, their fruiting trees. And the great thing about them is that they always have everything labeled so you know exactly where you're at. So let's just take a walk through here and I'm going to show you some of the plants that they have out here. So now we're gonna go down below and I'm gonna show you guys a little bit closely what they have down here. But as you can see, everything is labeled for you. So you have like shade hydrangeas, you have the sun hydrangeas, you have more vines down here, some more beautiful, beautiful shrubs down below. So let's go check out to see what's going on down here. Okay guys, so in this part of the garden, they have a lot of really great native plants, which is always really great to grow in your own garden because you know they're gonna thrive. But they really do have a great variety of some of my favorite natives here. Now let's actually go down to this area here, which is one of my favorite parts because you can find some really beautiful rhododendrons, and they have a nice variety of bamboo as well. All right, so as you guys can see, they do have a lot of beautiful proven winter plants here, which is really great because I know a lot of people are always looking for their hydrangeas and some of their other beautiful plants that they have. I know I'm always on the lookout for nurseries that carry proven winters. One of the things that I am loving this year for my garden are these beautiful limelight hydrangeas. I just picked a bunch of these up, but I do want to get a few of the tree forms because I think it would be really pretty to have these in big containers and then have annuals planted around them. So if you're not familiar with hydrangeas, I think these are one of the best varieties there is. Their blooms are absolutely beautiful. They age really well. There's a lot of fall interest in these. So just keep that in mind when you're looking for hydrangeas this season. So I wanted to highlight one of my favorite new shrubs this year. These are witch hazels, and I just added some of these to our garden. The great thing about them is that they come in a variety of colors. There's orange, there's red, there's yellow. We did get a couple of the Arnold Promise and a couple of these Helena. So the great thing about them is that they turn these beautiful colors during the fall and they bloom in late winter. And I think it's just a perfect pop of color to have in the garden when everything else is so dull during the winter time. And they just have a glowing effect. They're really, really beautiful. They have really great foliage as well. So if you're considering getting something with more fall and winter interest, I definitely recommend the witch hazels. So on this side of this area, they have some beautiful colors of rhododendrons. So I have this internal battle where I want them and then I don't, but every time I see one, I really want one, but I can never decide on the color. You know, I really like to wait until something really just hits me and it's like in your face and it's beautiful and you feel like you can't live without it. And I think I actually found the perfect specimen by their patio garden, which I'll show you guys in just a bit. But they really do have some really unique colors right over here. Actually, this is it right here. Just look at how beautiful this color is. This is a Percy Wiseman rhododendron. And I love how it's kind of a brighter pink on the outside and a very faint pink on the inside. I love that. I think I'm definitely gonna need to pick one up today. So now we're gonna just walk right back up, but you'll see more vines going all the way up. They have some beautiful star jasmines. I feel like these are becoming very popular this season. And I also really love these structural pieces they have here to add to your garden. I just wanted to point out this fountain. It just really stood out to me. Isn't that beautiful, guys? Oh. So gorgeous. And so right up here at the top of the vines, you'll see these beautiful double flower Japanese wisteria. We actually got one here last year and it's thriving, but they're just starting to put on their buds, or they have put on their buds, and they're going to be blooming pretty soon. But look at how beautiful that is. And it's like in a tree form. So gorgeous. Okay guys, so now we're gonna be entering this part of the nursery, and they do have this beautiful display garden here. There's a lot of inspiration to be drawn from this area. You can see how they've, you know, put two, you know, beautiful shrubs together. There's a beautiful fig tree. This is probably one of my favorite fig trees ever. It just gets so big every year, and they have just, it's just full of figs Right over here we have some beautiful dogwoods. They're just blooming right now and they're just such a beautiful tree in my opinion. We have one in our garden and it's gorgeous. I absolutely love the blooms that they set in springtime. And then further down we have some beautiful magnolia trees. I just picked up one here, I think about a month ago, and I think I'm gonna have to get a couple of more. Another whimsical thing about Cornell, they have this beautiful chicken coop, and you know, we're considering getting some chickens in our own garden, and I think I'm so inspired by the way that they did it. They have this beautiful vine growing up the coop, and it's just such a fun thing to see. Look at how cute they are, you guys. Oh, I love, look at the little black one. Oh, I get so excited when I see chickens. I don't know what it is. Okay, so here's a closer look at some of their magnolias. If you're looking for an evergreen tree, I think these are a great option for you. They have beautiful white blooms. They come in different sizes. This little gem dwarf is pretty popular. But the one magnolia that I got this spring was this stiletta over here. And it blooms in early springtime. It has the most beautiful white flowers. And it just has a really soft, gentle scent to them. And then right over here, you're gonna see some more magnolia. You're gonna see some lily of the valley. And then we'll enter their Japanese maple area. So if you guys didn't see in one of our last videos, we planted this Shishigashira lion's head maple. It's such a beautiful tree. Every time I see one, I want to get it, but we already have two in our garden. But who knows, I might get this little one and keep it in a planter. Now we're going to be entering the rose garden, and they have a variety of everything. They have Floribunda, Hybrid Tea, the Grand Flora, and then just down below they're going to have my favorite David Austin roses. So as you can see, they get a variety of different David Austins. Every year, this is where I get my roses for the most part. And they just have, I don't know, I think a David Austin rose just adds so much to your garden. They're such beautiful roses, and Cornell just gets these beautiful, healthy specimens every year. And right across from the rose garden, they have probably one of my favorite sections of the nursery, and that's their evergreen and conifer garden. They have some really cool specimens. One of the things that I'm loving this year are these weeping conifers. I think they're very fun to add to the garden. They provide some interest all year round. So let's get a closer look at some of the conifers that they have. So right off the conifer garden, there's this beautiful Cornell Farm Cafe. Keep in mind, they are still open, but they're doing takeout orders only right now. This is just such a fun place to come to grab coffee. They have excellent food here. The staff is so wonderful. They're so welcoming. And like I mentioned, the food is delicious. So keep that in mind when you're out. You know, you can kind of make this like a date with your friends or your family. You can come by plants. You can grab some food before you head home. So check them out next time you're here. So now we're going to be entering their patio, and this is where they have their annuals. They have other shrubs as well as perennials. And when you walk around, we'll notice that there are signs that kind of help you navigate where you are. So for example, some of these shrubs and flowers over here, these are gonna be deer resistant. Look at these beautiful lupine. I love the little clusters of flowers. They're so gorgeous. And over here we have some proven winner annuals. So I just picked up a lot of these guys for some of our hanging baskets and our container garden. So I'm very excited to get these in the ground and planted, or rather in the container and baskets and planted. So right over here, we have some beautiful ornamental grasses. I think it's really important to have grasses in your garden because it does add a different texture, and you can add them, you can mass plant a lot of these. So just keep that in mind if you have an area that you're struggling to fill it with something. These are a great option, in my opinion. And Cornell has a beautiful variety of different ornamental grasses. There's some great ground covers. Oh, look at the strawberry, it's shaped like a heart. guys, so now we're gonna enter the upper side of the farm where they'll have indoor plants on the inside, and they have more just shrubs and trees and flowering shrubs in this area of the garden. You'll also see there's fountains, and right off to my left here is where they have all of their pottery. And as you can see, they have a lot of different varieties. They have colors, they have some more modern pieces. So anything that you're looking for, you're gonna find it here at Cornell. So if you're into bonsai, there's a little bonsai section over here. They have quite a few varieties, and they're already, some of them are already planted up for you. Really cute, really nice shapes. So now we're going to enter their where you check out, and this is where they have their indoor plants. They have some really great varieties of a lot of different plants in here. Alright guys, well that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed walking around with me and seeing what this beautiful nursery has to offer. I'll link down their information down below for you guys, and make sure you follow them on Instagram because they do post regularly about everything that is going on at the nursery. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye bye.